show you, I'm going to give you one get off your chest. Show you, I'm going to give you one get off your chest. Show you, I'm going to give you one get off your chest. Show you, I'm going to give you one get off your chest. Show you, I'm going to give you one get off your chest.
My friend, let me take you into a world of sounds, images, and illustrious characters.
We met Erin at her dungeon, which is titled...
A Basement.
Right. And we did a photo shoot there, for Ray Gun.
I had been playing the Cantina sessions just repeatedly in the dungeon. I have yet to find a more perfect soundtrack, to which to sort of beat and bind to.
The Stooges and the Velvet Underground were the first bands I really got into. Iggy Pop is so sexy, and the Stooges were not afraid to break the boundaries. Iggy would cut and maim himself. He was real wild. He was out of control. This is our favorite bit of film ever.
So was Iggy a big hero of yours back then?
Oh yeah. I didn't tell him, but I saw him. I saw him on the Lust for Life tour.
Get into the car. We'll be the passenger. We'll ride through the city tonight. We'll see the city's ripped back sides. We'll see the bright and hollow sky and all the cars and black guitars.
He's one of the few people you meet who just like you howl and not. Incredibly high estimation, who actually just like kind of shoots way above what you kind of built him up to be, you know. We wrote a song for him, we wrote Aisha for him, and sent it to him cold, you know.
Did you guys like shit yourselves when he said yes?
The night before I started to read the Nick Kent book, The Dark Stuff, the Iggy chapter, I couldn't finish it, it's freaking me out too much.
Aisha, we're only just men, and I think you ought to know I'm a murderer. I have a portrait on my wall. He's a serial killer. I thought he wouldn't escape. Aisha, he got out. Aisha! I'm confused! Aisha! I'm vibrating!
We're sponsoring a new band. it's called The Velvet Underground. And we're trying to, well, since I don't really believe in painting anymore, I thought it would be a nice way of combining, and we have this chance to combine music and art and films all together, and we're sort of working on that, and the whole thing is being auditioned tomorrow.
I was just amazed. I mean, it was just like the way that, like, you know, like, kind of, first of all, someone could sign a band because, like, kind of, because an artist, a graphic designer, you know, promises that he'll do the sleeve, you know. I mean, that's basically what, you know, one of the main reasons, you know, the Velvet Underground was signed. Warhol said he would do the sleeve. And it's like, you know, and then, like, bringing together of the fact, you know, in the factory of all these different things, you know, film, and, you know, the plastics building, Inevitable, and, you know, the visuals and the live performance and J.R.I. cracking the whip, you know, it's just like, there's just so much going on. It's just like, it must have just blew people's heads away, you know.
Bands like the Velvets and the Stooges, the Jesus and Mary Chain offered a similar sort of angst. Jim Reed from the Jesus and Mary Chain collaborated on the record.